Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, yes, it is the second day of 2013, which means many people are trying to stick to resolutions and goals they've made, while others, well, they've already broken them. According to a new University of Scranton Journal of Clinical Psychology, the number one resolution is, yes, to lose weight. Coming in second is getting organized while spending less, and saving more comes in at number three. Other popular resolutions were to enjoy life to the fullest, stay fit, learn something exciting, and quit smoking. Study also said that 45% of Americans make resolutions, while 38% say they never do. Of those who do make them, only 8% are usually successful.
That is the hardest part.
It's pressure.
When I do think of something to have as my resolution,
yes,
I'll forget about it.
I know, yeah.
Halfway through the year. What was I trying to do again? Was this my goal?
I think I have too many, and so keeping up with all of them is going to be hard, but do you all have resolutions this year?
Well, I hate to be, you know, say like everybody else. I really want to lose weight, but it's extremely tough.
She's laughing.
She's laughing.
Because
Go ahead.
I'm only exercising, I think, is probably just mentioned the
Christmas cookies.
Yes, I did.
And in an hour or two, something's going to come out. You're going to eat the calzone in the kitchen.
I know.
You're going to eat the sweets.
Look, I'm doomed. I know.
I'm not saying it's impossible. It's just, I know you cave with sweets.
Oh my God, you know me too well. Oh man. Wow. Yeah, you know, I'm already thinking about the pizza, the calzones, and then she has some garlic things in the kitchen too, and I'm thinking about that too. And it's awful. The other thing, what I'm really going to try is I'm going to try to be a little more patient.
That's a good one.
I'm going to try. Because I have zero. When I say zero, you have no idea. I have zero patience.
Well, the holidays are over, so you're done putting up the lights and seeing them broken. Mm-hmm. So, you know.
But I think too, you have to make realistic resolutions, things that maybe aren't.
Are you saying the ones I made aren't realistic?
No. I think what you said, you'd be a little more patient.
Sure.
So maybe just, you know, gradual things that you'll slowly chip away at.
Baby steps.
Too many people feel the pressure of a New Year's
That's
resolution.
True.
You have the whole year.
Mm-hmm.
You have the entire year. So don't think come, you know, March, if you haven't, you know, lost a pound or if you, you know, have already.
Why is the camera on me?
That's a really good point, Michaela. You know,
you have to feel
less stressed about achieving that goal right away.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just spread it out and have little goals for each quarter of the year, I would say.
Exactly. Maybe make a couple and just, you know, make them.
I feel like I should be laying down on the couch like I'm going to speak to the psychiatrist. Like you two are giving me a pep talk on how I'm going to make it through 2013. And everyone else at home.
I currently do not have one. But I already have to weed out everything I did yesterday and say, well, it can't be any of those things, so.
Well, now that I'm back in Rhode Island, one of my resolutions is to spend more time with family and to explore Rhode Island. I feel like I, you know, haven't really done that a lot.
Right.
So I'm really, really thrilled to do that.
And that's what they say. They're always saying when you do make a resolution, don't make something that's completely unattainable.
Yes.
Because it adds a lot of pressure, and everybody knows everyone has enough pressure as it is, just getting through your life on a daily basis. Never mind tossing in something like losing weight or one of these other things.
Right, or quitting smoking.
Maybe
it's just bring it down to, you know, one a day or something if you're someone that smokes half a pack or a handful of them. Like I said, I think we're all agreeing on that. Make it achievable.
Yeah, nothing is going to, you know, the new year doesn't come and a switch goes off and everybody's going to be in that mode because, as we know, that doesn't happen today.
You'll see it at the gym, though.
I was going to say, for the next couple of weeks, you'll see it at the gym. All those people who never go will be there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's tough.
Give that till the end of the month.
Right. Absolutely.
A lot of our Facebook friends were, of course, weighing in. Isn't that right, Megan?
Yes, and here is what our Facebook friends are saying. Mark Anthony Simonson says he'll be getting some dental work done and try out for the next year's Rhode Show Search for a Star. You should do it.
Hang on, Mark.
Megan
just started. Let her have her year. And then...
God, somebody's already want to steal the buzz.
It's okay. It's fun. Hank Sinatra Jr. also weighed in saying, I'm going to focus on being healthier by working out and eating better, and I want to be more productive as soon as I finish Lost on Netflix.
So he's not rushing into anything.
Yeah, he's taking his time.
Dude, I can tell you how Lost ends.
Which season? Donna Michelle is going to make small positive changes in my life one day at a time. When you set small goals, you have a better chance of accomplishing it, thus making yourself feel good. Win-win.
Good idea.
Absolutely.
With a smile. I like that.
Ryan Pettibon says, my resolution is to do more random acts of kindness.
Nice.
That's also a good thing. Well. Also a good thing.